How's it going, guys? Welcome to Audio Addiction. We have 44blonde with us tonight. He can say his name and what he does.
What's up? I'm 44blonde. I make music, I songwrite, do all that.
There we go. Well, want to give a huge shout out to the team. Listen, they made it happen, so I was definitely stoked. Big shout out to Eden for getting this hooked up. She's awesome, so big salutes to her. But wanted to know about... I did take a look on while I was sitting here at my computer desk, and I had seen you had done some other podcasts recently, and just to kind of get myself familiarized with what you do, because beyond, you know, getting the email to have you on, I like to try to do my research. So it looks like recently you moved out to LA and you're getting started, you know, getting signed. You had a bunch of cool shit happen, which is awesome. But what was like the origin story? What kind of got you started out in music? Is your family like musical? Like what really got you initially started into wanting to make and be in the music business?
I started making music back when I was in high school.
Okay.
And just kind of like, it was just with some buddies who knew how, and I didn't really like know how, but I thought it was like fun and cool, whatever. And it was awful. But it was a fun time though. Like got to like hang out with them and like just kind of keep me out of trouble a bit. And so yeah, then I just started doing that, and like I just felt like real excited every time I put something out, even if no one was really even listening to it, mm-hmm. or they were not liking whatever. I just like enjoyed that feeling. So I just kept doing it for years and years and just improving, and here I am.
There we go. I feel like with each iteration, it's gotten better. Like I had said before, I had taken a look at some of your music, your most recent song, 911. I'll leave links to go listen to the new song and obviously all of the social media as well. But I try to do my due diligence on listening to everything. So I checked everything from She Loves Drugs to At Least I Know Your Name. Should have stayed home, and obviously 911, which is the new one, and you have a new song that's coming out Friday as well, which very stoked to listen to. I heard a little clip on Instagram, and I was like, wow, this is different from the previous stuff. How do you feel like you've kind of evolved as an artist? Because I feel like from the initial stuff that you released like roughly around a year ago, till now, I feel like there's such a variation in your sound and how you kind of have improved over that time frame. So how do you feel like, as being kind of at the obviously driver's seat of everything, do you feel like with each song you're just like, man, there's something like musically that I could do differently on this track to make it more interesting? Or do you just try to just go into it and just say whatever happens is going to happen in the track?
I mean, I used to have a different project. Like, this 44blonde one is, like, fairly new. It's, like, a year old, maybe. I had another project that was doing pretty well back in the day, like, for being independent, whatever. And it was, like, a lot more pop music, kind of.
Okay.
And then, like, I don't know. Right now, I just, like, switched it up, and I'm trying to really just test out a bunch of different sounds. I mean, I've got songs anywhere from like borderline country almost songs to like rock and roll to the one coming out is real poppy to like all different stuff. So I mean, like, I just you know, I enjoy making it all, so I'm kind of seeing what other people enjoy and then just kind of run with it. So I'm still so early with it, but I can do that. I can test things out without whatever.
Yeah, without segregating people. I feel like your music, I feel like with the stuff that's been released thus far, even from At Least I Know Your Name to You Should Have Stayed Home, I feel like those kind of are in the same, like, sort of, like, grouping. And then 911, I feel like, is a little bit more in that, like pop, like more mainstream, like pop punk music, which is great because that's the type of stuff that I'm into. But I'm very curious to hear your take on more of the like country style stuff, because personally that's not my lane of music, but I feel like you could handle it in terms of like different sounds and incorporating that into your music. So I'm very curious in how you would go about doing that. So I'll have to stick around and see what's going on with that. But the new song was very poppy too. So
Yeah, I mean, it's just, I lived in St. Louis growing up, and then that was, like, just everyone around me was making rap music, really. So I was just kind of like, how could I be a part of that. So I was like, all right, well, I can like sing choruses for these rappers and stuff like that. So I got into more like that, and then it kind of turned into like me doing some poppier stuff. And then I went to Arkansas for 4 years for college.
Ah.
Really introduced into like a lot of country stuff, and like the stuff I've been like making kind of for fun almost. It's not like real country. It's more like southern rock. That's more what I like really grew up on. So it just kind of has a bit of a twang to some parts of it.
All right. All right. I could definitely see that. That would be really cool to hear. So I have to be keeping my eyes and my ears open for some new 44 Blonde, which I'm very excited about. Like I said, the newest song has this real kind of like pop hook to it. And I was like listening to that little clip again on Instagram. Go check it out, guys. And it definitely is different comparatively to some of the other stuff that you've released that far. So I do think that I kind of was thinking in my head, I was like, he's very much like a chameleon. He can kind of like shape shift and do different things where it still has his like main like ethos in terms of like sound, but then you could switch it up by having more of like a pop beat behind it, or have more of a like an MGK style kind of like pop punk, like almost emo kind of vibe to it. And then I'm curious again how you're going to spin it even more on different songs. So again, I'm going to keep my eyes peeled. It's going to be very sick. I'm very excited.
I got a lot of songs with like orchestrated and choir infused parts in it coming up soon.
Oh too, man. So. All right. All right. Yeah. Holding it's it down.
Fall. Yeah.
There we go. And then the next question I have for you is, you know, who, you know, we did talk about like the earlier years about like how you started out, but who were some of the artists that really inspired you to, you know, become an artist? Because I feel like a lot of the times I love to kind of get a base knowledge for, you know, where you started out in terms of the influences, and then who influences your styles more now, because I feel like it might be more vast and variety filled.
Yeah, I mean, I grew up listening to, like I said, like southern rock, like the Allman Brothers and Tom Petty and Bob Dylan and shit like that. And and then like I found kind of like surfer pop, I guess you could explain it, in high school.
Wow.
Like,
all right,
like Felly and like some of these other guys that I was like, that's kind of cool. So I kind of tried to do that a bit, but then like I never got any like proper singing training or anything. I just like bought a bunch of Otis Redding CDs and started smoking cigarettes and tried to make myself sound raspy growing up. So that's kind of, I just try to mock those CDs while driving around every day, kind of where I led to here. So
there we go. Yeah. It's quite a journey, but we're now at 44 Blonde. So I feel like everything surrounding that, again, is really interesting. So again, very excited. And then for people who maybe aren't familiar with your music, do you have a song that you would recommend to a new listener that would kind of give them an idea of what you're going for? Like, you know, who you are as an artist?
I think that what's out right now, I think Should Have Stayed Home has the best description of the way I've been living, whatnot. It's the most true song, I suppose, and most relatable to others, I feel. But overall, I mean, I don't know. I got so much stuff like coming that's so much better than anything I have out right now that I'm really excited about, that I've been able to tell a full story throughout. So I'm excited.
There we go. It might be like an EP, an album. Who knows? We'll all be here. Patiently waiting for some new stuff. And I did notice that from, again, kind of doing some of the research, you're working or I think you live with Little Aaron, which is really cool. How has that process been? Has he kind of helped you like fine tune and like tailor what you're doing? Because I feel like he is doing some really great stuff as well. So do you kind of like throw ideas at him and say like, okay, this is what I'm feeling, this is what I'm doing now, what do you think about this? Is he like kind of a good person to just like bounce ideas off of?
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, he's an incredible artist, incredible songwriter. He's the one who found me. I mean, anything I make that I'm like really stoked on, I'll definitely send his way and get his opinion. And his opinion definitely matters probably the most out here to me. So yeah, I mean, if he's really liking it, like this next song I'm putting out, it's his favorite song that I've done. So like it made me real pumped about it. So yeah, it's just, he definitely has a big influence on everything I'm doing out here for sure.
There we go. Shout out to Lil Aaron. That's awesome. I feel like it's always cool when, you know, when you see other artists interact with each other, and how, I don't know, I kind of find it similarly to, you know, how much care and time I kind of take into the artists I have on here. Like, I really want them to just, like, do some awesome stuff. And, like, if there's any platform that I can try to, like, push their music out there, then I'm going to do it. So I feel like he's always in the comments of every post that you're doing. So I know it's, like, a legit, like, love that he wants you to do well. So that's an awesome feeling.
Yeah, no, I mean, he's great. So I'm excited to see where that takes us. We actually may or may not have a song together coming out soon-ish.
All right. Oh, there we go. All right. There we go. I like it. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Yeah. The next question I have for you, I have to ask this, as just kind of, again, scrolling through the gram, and I saw you post a photo with Young Gravy, and it says cousin session. I have to know, are you guys actually cousins? Because that's kind of wild. That is wild. I just wanted to, I saw that, and I was like, is he just, like, flexing on, like, Instagram that he's like, are we actually cousins? But now you guys are legitimately cousins. That's kind of
wild. You gotta ask him.
All right. I'm gonna have to I'm gonna have to Twitter DM him and ask him. So
run it up. I'll tell him to check it out.
That's so crazy. So shout out to Young Gravy. I don't know if you watch this, but that's wild. The next question I have for you is, what are you listening to more currently? I always love asking this question because I feel like as I get older and as this channel gets older, I always like to have a lot of variety. So what are you currently spinning that you just been vibing with right now?
I'm looking at my Spotify right now because I don't know.
I don't even know, honestly.
I'm listening to a lot of like drill music right now, honestly, like 504 and... Pop Smoke, just like on repeat, honestly. And then got a lot of Rihanna in here too. My boy Sachi, I've got a couple of his songs listed in here. A little Ice Spice. Ooh. I've been getting a little spicy with it.
All right. Yeah, that new I gotta say that Rihanna track on the Black Panther soundtrack is also really good. So
Rihanna's amazing.
I feel like she's low-key getting back into music. I'm hoping she kind of said she was taking a hiatus, but maybe it might be Rihanna season soon. So we'll have to keep an eye out.
Yeah.
Who knows? Sure. Rihanna, I know you watch the channel. So 44blonde, come on.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Collab. It's going to be sick. Yeah. But the next question I have for you is another fun one. If you could pick a song to cover, what song would you like to cover?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know. I really don't know. Yeah, I don't have an answer for that one. Yeah. I don't know. I feel like
you could do an Allman Brothers song. I feel like that'd be kind of sick. You could hold it down. Make it like more modern.
I've messed around with some like Bob Dylan covers and Tom Petty covers before.
They're
just like, they're fun. I don't know. I'd almost rather do like a remix of a song, just like hop on a verse of someone else's track.
Okay. Who would you love to hop on like a remix version? I'm curious now.
I still want to hop on Drugs remix by Aaron. That would be fire, but I don't know.
Aaron.
Yeah.
My man, come on.
Yeah.
That'd be sick. I would check it out. Aaron, come on, man. I know we don't know that each other that well, but like that would be sick. Also, guys, if you're seeing something running around, it's my cat. He's currently zooming. So if you do see that, shouts to my cat Meatball. He's running around somewhere. But the next question I have for you is, funnily enough, we did talk about remixes, but if there was a collab track you would want to drop with someone, is there anyone specific that you're just like, man, I'd love to do a collab with them?
A lot of those people I'm making happen that I don't want to say yet, so I don't know yet. But honestly, I think it would be like my dream collab would be making a song with Chief Keef.
Ooh, all right.
It was like crazy. I think it'd be sick.
All right, guys. Listen, I know Twitter is hitting the shithole, but we're gonna do whatever we can to get this happen. So what you do is you open your Twitter app, you tag 44blonde, you tag Chief Keef, say collab ? Listen, I didn't go to law school. I'm not a legal scholar, but, you know, I just want to say it might be a contract, you know, so. You never know. So if you want to make that happen, go do it for my man out here. So that would be very sick. next question I have for you, keeping it more current, I know that a lot of bands recently have been getting back together, or artists, like, you know, coming back out of retirement and, you know, making music again. Is there any specific artists that you can think of that you would love for just to come back and be like, yo, we're making music again, what's good?
I really don't listen to that much stuff of actually, my answer to that would be The Neighborhood.
Ooh, yeah. All right.
Yeah. If they came out with another album, I'd lose it. Yeah.
I feel like secretly they're like, all right, he said the code word. All right, we're gonna drop the album.
Yeah, you never know.
Who knows? It's got it all locked up. We'll see. Neighborhood,
Jesse.
Drop that album. Let's go. Yep. Let's go. I know you're sitting on something, but the next question I have for you is another good one. Obviously, you know, you do singing, but if there was another musical instrument you could master, what would it be?
I know how to play guitar, but I would love to be able to play piano. Piano would be okay. My favorite. I feel like that's one thing I wish I would have learned when I was younger. That or like harmonica.
Ooh, just a sick harmonica shred. I feel about it, you know? Yeah. I think you could throw it in there, you know? Just,
you don't know. I used to try to learn the harmonica, and my mother always got pissed at me. It was so annoying. So, and I tried to play drums in middle school and like the band, and then that was horrible because they never let me actually play the drums. I was on the xylophone, and so that was brutal. Yeah.
Oh, no.
So, stuck with guitar, really. Yeah.
Oh man, resignated to the xylophone. That's that's rough. I feel that.
I don't know. I always wanted to touch the drum set. They never let me.
Yeah, I think it's like, you know, when you're a kid, they can't just let like kids loose on like a drum kit. You know, there's just too much shit going on, and they're like, we can't have any of that. Yeah, and then now you're just making music, so now you can. You can be like, listen, I can play drums now whenever I want. I'm a recording artist, so
I'm just not good at them.
But the next question I have for you is, obviously, as you can tell, I'm a major nerd, so I love to ask this question. If you could be a video game character, who would you be?
I gotta be honest, I don't play video games.
Oh yeah. Man, that's a damn shame.
I grew up with some strict parents, and I had to go outside and play sports.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Yeah, I played Madden, but that's about it.
I feel that.
Yeah. Sorry, I don't have an answer for that one.
I do feel like you could have, I mean, you do got The Simpsons, you got Bart in the back, so I feel you could rock with some Bart.
Is there a video game?
Yeah, there's a couple, but I feel like I feel like that'd be kind of sick. I think that'd be neat.
Could be dope.
I feel that on like being like having strict parents though. I kind of feel that vibe. So, you know, my parents are like, listen, you can play for an hour, but then you got to be like outside for the rest of the day, and they'll just yoink you out. So let us know in the comments if you have strict parents. Love to know. You're going to end up like a 44 blonde, baby.
Listen up, you're going to end up like me.
There you go. The next question I have for you is, if you were to compile a dream tour line of 44 Blonde, who would you love to have on this tour?
Dream tour. I'd obviously need Aaron. I'd need everybody who lives here. Jackie Boy, I'd need him. I'd need like all the boys, Smart Death, Lotus, all them. But then I just like being around all them. And then other than that, like, I don't know. It's a good question. I anybody who's just like a good time to be around, really. I just kind of worry about myself. If they want to come, have a good time, then that's cool.
I feel that. Yeah. You gotta have like the homie squad, you know. And I feel like you're very much like, I gotta have the homies with me, you know. And I respect that because I also the deep, same way. You gotta squad up.
Yeah, exactly. Nothing better.
That's like the best feeling. Is like just when you roll up to a show and all the homies are there. That's the best. Yeah. I love that. So, you know, listen, I would love to be a part of that. So, I mean, guys, I don't know how we're going to make this happen, but let's do it. I think it would be just like, they should call it the Homies Tour. And, you know, it'd be all across the states. So keep your eyes peeled. It might be coming up sooner than you think. 2023. But, the next question I have for you, 44 Blonde, is, you know, kind of on a similar vein, in your opinion, who puts on a great live performance in terms of artists you've seen live?
I think one of the best shows I've seen since moving out here was Beauty School Dropouts.
Oh,
you know them.
I do.
They're fucking awesome live, I will say. Aaron throws a great show. I just saw him. Swicko throws a great show. I just saw him. Yeah, I mean, just like a lot of people. I mean, I've been to a lot of shows recently. Kid G, that was one of the best shows I've ever been to. So sick.
Kid G. Yeah. All right, yeah. I'll have to check it out because I feel like for me, like I said, when Eden had approached me to have you on, I was like, I don't know too much about like what he does, but I'm gonna check out his, like, you know, his band obviously, and like, you know, his following, who he's with, and like I found so many cool artists. Like, again, Beauty School Dropout came up on my like Spotify, and I was like, yo, this is so good. Like, how did I not? It always surprises me. Like, Spotify has this way of like throwing artists into like my recommended feed. And it's a little scary, if I'm going to be honest. Like, you know, you're like listening to it. And I was like, oh, yeah, having 44blonde on the channel. And then I get Beauty School Dropout as like my next song, you know, band. And I'm like, yo, what's going on here? This is kind of wild. So I do like that in that case. And I feel like, again, I like their music and it does mesh well with yours. So I feel like if there's ever to be a tour, I feel like you guys would work so well together. So I don't know who we have to hit up, but let's do it, you know. Throw Black Bear on there. Let's go, you know. I'm about it. That'd be an awesome tour. So the next question I have for you, 44blonde, is what is your favorite TV show, favorite movie?
Seinfeld is my favorite TV show. Wow. Watch that like every night, just trying to fall asleep. So I'd have to say that. And then favorite movie would be The Godfather 1 and 2.
Ooh, classics, you know?
Yeah.
That's the Al Pacinos, you know? Iconic. Also, you know, you did mention this earlier about moving out to L.A. How has that process been for you? Because I can imagine, you know, when you went to school in Arkansas and you lived in St. Louis, there's a lot of traveling and stuff. And, you know, obviously living in LA, there's a lot of music that goes on there. Do you feel like, you know, looking back on moving to LA, do you feel like that's been a very like good experience for you in regards to just like being out there and being close to, like, I imagine LA has got such a great like music scene, certainly. So has that been like a good response on your end for that?
Yeah, no, I think it's been a great thing for me. Moving out here has put me in a lot of positions that I wouldn't have been in if I wasn't here. It's not, out here is not as glamorous as people may think it is from outside, though, I will say that. But no, I mean, overall, like, I couldn't be happier anywhere else, so I'm glad I'm out here.
There we go. Well, 44blonde, I also have to ask connection with that question is for people who are starting out, and I feel like your rise like has been so great, whether it be on like TikTok as well as, you know, like your actual music, like the You Should Have Stayed Home has like 70,000 views on it, which is awesome. Do you have any advice for like younger artists that are like checking your music out and are like, yo, this guy's sick, like, how do I like get started doing this? Like, is there any advice that you would have loved to have like getting into the scene and, you know, that helped you out?
Just not being afraid to hit anybody up. Like, I would be in everyone's DMs just like, yo, like, I love your music here and there, and just like building those connections when I was still like thousands of miles away. Mm-hmm. And then suddenly like you get a couple of those people on your side, and then like people are like, oh, like, they rock with them. So it kind of just snowballs into like more and more people, and suddenly like you've got this whole like just like list of people that you can hit up and work with or whatever. And so, yeah, just being able to write a proper message to someone, being able to communicate in a professional manner, but also, like, I don't know, just knowing when to stop talking as well.
That's true. I feel like sometimes you know, people always ask me too, because they're like, oh, well, you know, you have a YouTube channel, like, you know, how do you navigate, like, you know, having people on and stuff. And I'm just like, you know, honestly, if you come correct in the DMs and you're just like, yo, man, really like your content, even if you don't watch it, like, I'd rather you just be like straight up front and be like, hey, haven't watched your stuff, but like someone else recommended me you, and I'm going to go check your stuff out. I'd love to come on your channel. And then I think that's like the best way to do it. And I find that sometimes I you know, I have to agree with you, 44blonde. Like, it's just, you have to like be honest with like whoever you're speaking with. And I think regardless of what you say, I think honesty can be like told within like text. So, you know,
and just like even outside of music, just like learn how to like send proper messages to people. That's my first thing my dad taught me, like whenever I was like in high school, and just kept butchering me about it. It's like, you gotta be able to sound professional to people.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah. So yeah, to all the listeners out there, just like,
have the respect, you know?
Yeah. Learn to properly. Don't say yo, like,
just, I don't know. You know, unless you guys are homies, then you can say whatever you want, you know?
Right. Right. So yeah, that's my little piece of advice for the day to whoever's watching.
Love it. I love that, you know, because I feel like, again, your rise on TikTok has been really good. I gave you a follow because I hadn't followed you on TikTok yet. So I'm, you know, one more down. You know, and I think like even your following on Instagram too has like massively blown up. I was like taking a look at some of the stats and I'm just like, damn, this guy's really doing it. So, you know, much salutes to you, man. You're doing some great shit. So I'm excited to take a look at 2023 and what you're doing next. But have to ask this question as well. If you were trapped on a desert island and there was one album you can bring with you for the next month to listen to, what album would that be?
Layla by Derek and the Dominoes. It's been the same album forever.
Ooh, all right. I haven't heard that one. I'll have to go give it a listen after this now.
Second would be Beer Bongs and Bentleys by Post Malone.
Oh, so, that was the other artist that I was thinking of, and I couldn't place it. But I feel like you and Posty would work so well
together.
That would
be a dream tour. That's number one dream tour.
Posty, listen.
Yeah.
I know you watch my stuff. I love you. So thank you. Thank you for being here, taking that time out. But get my man 44blonde on a tour, like.
I mean, no.
I'll come out, you know. So let's go. I would do it. Let's get it, make it happen. I would be about it. So guys, let's gather together, and let's petition that shit. Let's go. I'm about it. Gotta do it. Gotta do it. But the next question I have for you, 44blonde, is a question that I ask a lot at the close of my interviews, and I feel like it's always a good send off. So. Not to pressure you in any way, but I feel like you're gonna hit me with the greatest answer I could hear tonight. So I'm very excited. But what do you want people to take away from what you do as an artist? Like, you create and people like your shit or people don't like your shit, whatever, you still create because you love to create. So tell people, why do you make music? Why, who are you trying to speak to, or, you know, give the people kind of like an idea of why you decide to create music? Because I feel like we all love it, but people do it for different reasons, certainly.
Yeah, I mean, I would say my biggest reason for making it would just, it's not for anybody. It's for myself. It's an outlet for me. I struggle articulating my words about certain things, but it gives me that route of being able to do that. And just honestly, a lot of the messages that I put out in the songs is just like you're gonna fuck up and like just fucking rock out while doing it, basically. You know, like, it is what it is, and don't care what anybody says or thinks, because, I mean, at the end of the day, we're all gonna fucking die one day. It won't matter. Like, we're a minuscule in this whole fucking world, so it's fine, you know? And this, it's just one way for me to tell everybody to fuck off, but also, like, I love the people who rock with me, you know?
I got you. And I even checked out this one article from Early Rising. I'll give a shout out to Liam, who wrote it. He was talking about the one single that you released, which is At Least I Know Your Name. and he was just talking about the interesting fact of how you wrote this song based off of, you know, one person, and you're talking about all of these sort of fictitious women that you're kind of identifying the, like, pros and cons of these relationships and stuff. And I thought that was really interesting, because I think from my perspective, obviously it's cool to hear other people, you know, talking about your music. But I think, like, I went and listened to the song after I had read this, and I think it put a lot of things in perspective more. Like, I was listening to it, and I was like, oh, okay, like, this is, like, and just kind of to follow up with, like, being articulate, I think that the way that you did the lyricism in that track specifically was really thought out, and I gotta give you kudos on it, because I think sometimes when we think about music, we're like, yo, this is bump, like, am I vibing with this one? But I feel like with this song, I was really, like, vibing with the actual music, but then taking the time to listen to the lyrics, and I was like, this is really articulated, like, in a way that I feel like, you know, most pop punk artists are just like, they'll just go and talk about whatever shit they want, but I felt like with this, it was just so thought out, and I gotta give you a lot of kudos for that, because I think for me, that was what sucked me in, and then I listened to the rest of the stuff, and I was like, yo, ride or die now, you know? He's on 44 Blondes on the list now, so I feel like for me, that was really cool. Do you feel like when you see, like, articles like that, where people really kind of articulate how you're writing these lyrics, is that, like, that must be a great feeling to know that, you know, your connection lyrically is meeting someone else's, like, thought process and being like, oh shit, he knows exactly what I'm thinking about. That's so crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I think every article, like, I like reading them, whether, like, they're good or bad, because everything I write about in every song, like, none of it's made up. All of it's true. And so I like just, like just really hearing other people's, like, takes on something that actually happened, and, like, them kind of, like, taking it into their own reality or whatever. So I think it's real interesting that way, in that aspect.
Yeah, and I think I feel like, it almost, in a sense, like, the truth about the actual situation, like, will remain a mystery, you know? And that's, like, one of the coolest things about, like, music, because it can be, like, articulated in so many different ways and understood in different ways that you're like, I love when artists are like, okay, it's up to your own interpretation. I wrote it for me, but, like, it's up for you to decide how this story pertains to you. And I feel like this is, I feel like that song specifically, and I'll have to go and listen to some of the other songs to kind of get a better idea, but that one more specifically was one that I was like, yeah, like, it was really thought out, and I didn't think about it from that perspective, but I guess Liam picked up on it in that way, and so I, you know, I thought that was really cool, so I wanted to point out that article and give a salute to Liam. So,
yeah,
Liam, big shouts. But the last thing, 44 Blonde, the reason you're on here, tell the people where they can find you at on social media, what you have coming up in the next couple months. This is going to be going out, like, early, mid-December. So if you got anything cool you would like to announce, do it now.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, I mean, you can find me on Instagram at it's44blonde. On, like, everything else, I'm pretty sure it's just at 44blonde. And then, yeah, I mean, I've got a song dropping this Friday, November 18th. So I guess it'll be out by then.
It'll be out, yes.
And then, yeah, we got some big features, big songs coming out, like, I don't know, probably February of next year.
Ooh.
Just going to, like, keep rocking them, keep rocking the singles, like, every month and a half until something happens, till I go on a tour or whatever. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Well, I'm hoping, listen, fingers crossed, 2023, I see some 44 Blonde in Philly. I would love to see in Philly, so I'll be keeping my eyes peeled. My eyes will be locked to the Instagram page, just like you should be. Links in the description to check out 44 Blonde. Again, if you're into, like, pop punk, alternative emo music, and then, like, any smattering of, like, pop music, listen, I found the guy for you. So please go check out 44 Blonde. All the links will be below, his social media, his YouTube page. Make sure to give a subscribe to that, so you know when new songs drop. Or even better yet, you can go give him a follow on Spotify, because then you'll know when new heat is out. So please go do it. If you enjoyed this interview, share, like, and subscribe. It will also be in audio format on Spotify, Apple Music, all that jazz. So keep your ears and eyes loaded on that. But again, want to give a massive shout-out to 44blonde for coming on, and obviously Eden as well. Thank you.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it. Had a stellar time.